This lesson is about the stages of social casework, which is the core and direct methods of social work. The major purpose of this lesson is to introduce the different stages of social casework so that the practice of social casework can be done objectively. Some of the objectives set for this lesson are: on the completion of this lesson, you should be able to first know the meaning, definition of social casework. Second, know the stages of social casework. Third, understand the role of social caseworker in the different stages of social casework. First, understand what is social work. Social work is a professional discipline and is of recent origin. Social work for many years was thought as social service. Even today in our society, the misconception still prevails, and this could be one of the reasons why social work and social work education has not been recognized and developed unlike other disciplines. Social work is complex and dynamic as it deals with the psychosocial problems and the deficiencies which exist in the relationship between the individual and his social environment. Social work, in a nutshell, is to help individuals, families, groups, and communities identify their problems, personal and or social, and try to solve these problems with the help of a social worker who is a guide or a facilitator and a catalyst. To be a professional social worker, one needs to acquire the knowledge, skills, and techniques to deal with individuals and their behaviors in the society, and also their reaction to the social problems they are confronting in their own lives. Social work is a practice of providing care and assistance for the physically, mentally and socially challenged individuals in the society. Now that we have seen what social work is, let's try to move on and understand what is social casework. Social casework is one of the core and direct methods of social work. In fact, there was social casework long before social workers began. It is also one of the oldest methods of social work practice. It is concerned with the development of individuals, adjustment and use of resources that are available in one's environment and also within. Social casework helps to develop the social functioning of individuals in the society. Social casework is one of the methods of reaching out to the marginalized, the vulnerable people in society, the distressed, and also to individuals who need help in the different stages of life, say from a childhood to an elderly. Problem solving is the intent behind every social casework process. The caseworker does not solve the problem for the client, but helps the person in the situation to be equipped in solving or facing the problem adequately. In other words, the role of a social caseworker is that of a guide or a facilitator and not a person who makes decisions for the client's problems on behalf of the client. Every individual in the society is unique. Each individual's personality is a product of one's nature and nurture. Each individual reacts differently to one's social, economic, and physical environment, and as such, problems of one individual is different from the problems of other individual. Social casework, therefore, cannot follow the same format in helping the client resolve one's problem. Social casework is an individualized service in the field of social work. The objectives of social casework is to make a good rapport with the people in the society, find out, understand, and solve the problems of the individuals and also to help the individual to identify resources from within and outside of the individual, that is environment, in resolving the problem. The social case worker should also empower the client to solve similar or other problems faced by the client in the future. There are four components of casework known as the four P's, that is the person, the problem, the place and the process. The social caseworker must be able to understand the problem of the client based on the facts shared by the client. The caseworker should also be a good active listener and must be able to identify the opening statement of the client. Now let's see the definition of social casework. Social casework may be defined as the art of doing different things for and with different people by cooperating with them to achieve at one and the same time their own and society's betterment. This definition was given by Mary Richmond in the year 1917. Social casework is a method employed by social worker to help individuals find solution to problems of social adjustment which they are unable to handle in satisfactory way by their own efforts. This definition was given by Gordon Hamilton in the year 1954. Social casework is a process used by certain human welfare agencies to help individuals to cope more effectively with their problems in social functioning. This definition was given by Perlman in the year 1957. Now let's look at the stages of social casework. The process of social casework is a systematic and professional method of assisting individuals cope with their problem. The various stages of the social casework are phase 1, study or intake phase. In this phase, the social caseworker tries to explore the person who has come with a problem seeking for professional help. The caseworker in this phase will have to understand the problem of the client without much delay, that is without taking much time. The problem will have to be understood from the client's perspective. The relationship of the client with the other members who are directly or indirectly involved in the problem which the client is facing, the environment in which the client is in, and the interrelationship of the client with the environment and the problem. The social caseworker will have to ensure that the client interacts with the caseworker about the problem, thereby making the client participate in the problem solving process. This is a crucial phase in the social casework process as it is here the client decides whether to continue with the services of the caseworker and also the caseworker decides whether the necessary skills and techniques required in handling the problem of the client is possessed by the caseworker. Therefore, it is essential that in this phase the contact had to be productive and constructive. The different principles and values of social casework will have to be expressed by the caseworker, like maintaining confidentiality, understanding the worth and dignity of the client, accepting and respecting the client, controlled emotional involvement by the caseworker, and so on. In this phase, the social caseworker will have to be an active listener and must be able to understand the problem of the client from the perspective of the client. Recording of the problem will also have to be done in the same manner. In the intake phase, The case worker should be able to understand the attitude of the client to one's problem. It is also essential to inform the client of the relationship between the client and the case worker. In most hospitals, this phase is more like an administrative procedure, preparing the case sheet of the client. Now let's move to the second phase, that is the assessment phase. The second stage of the social casework is the assessment of the problem. The focus in this phase is to get to know more about the problem of the client. Here, a thorough understanding of the problem of the client by using the skills and techniques of social casework like questioning, interviewing, and sometimes confronting the client. The nature of the problem, the cause of the problem should be defined and described to the client. The strength and weakness of the client will have to be made known to the client, as this will aid in the coping strategies to be used by the client in the problem solving process. The assessment phase should be communicative in the sense the client should be able to share the problem, expressing the problem with appropriate emotions. The client should be helped to realize that the problem faced by the client can be resolved by the client only if it is broken down into smaller attainable goals, and that the problem cannot be resolved within a day. The smaller goals should follow the principle of SMART, that is, specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time-bound, as this will enable the client to understand the problem better. The goals set should be by the client and not by the caseworker. This process will enable the client to learn the process of problem solving. The information about the problem collected by the caseworker should be summarized so that the client is able to understand that the caseworker has understood the problem from the perspective of the client, and also the client has a clear understanding of the problem. The summary of the problem recorded by the caseworker will have to be written in the chronological order, and facts pertaining to the problem should be recorded. Other information which are not relevant to the problem but adds to the understanding of the problem need to be recorded. The caseworker at the end of the assessment phase should be able to plan the intervention phase. Now let's move to the third phase, that is the intervention phase. In this phase, the social caseworker starts to implement the intervention plan for the client, that is, to implement the set of goals planned in the assessment phase by both the client and the caseworker. The intervention can be a direct method where there is a face-to-face interaction between the client and the caseworker. Counseling is one of the methods in the intervention phase. Environmental modification is another aspect in the intervention phase. The problem expressed by the client is connected to the environment in which the client is in. Therefore, it is essential that an alteration in the environment of the social system in which the client is connected with is modified to suit to the convenience of the client. The environmental modification may sometimes be essential for the better functioning of the client. The SMART goals set should be implemented in the order of simple to the complex. The goals set should be attainable, as this will encourage, motivate, and inspire the client to proceed further. The self-confidence of the client will also be enhanced. Sometimes During this phase, referral services are also done in order to help the client resolve the problem. This will also create awareness in the client that there are other individuals in the society who are undergoing similar situations. The goal of the intervention phase thus is to reduce the problem and improve the functioning of the client. The intervention should not only be at the individual level, but should also include the use of resources that are available in the organization and the community. The caseworker should support the client to improve the weakness of the client and to utilize one's strength to overcome one's own weaknesses. This makes the client strong and to be prepared to face future challenges in one's life with confidence. This insight provided by the caseworker will help the client to have a better caseworker-client relationship. After the intervention process is complete, the caseworker should record the intervention phase, as this will help in evaluating the intervention process. Now let's move on to the fourth phase, which is the termination phase. Termination is an important phase in the casework process. In this phase, the client is prepared by the social caseworker to be independent. The termination phase will have to be planned properly, and termination should be a gradual process. The social caseworker cannot abruptly stop the caseworker-client relationship. Termination refers to the process when the caseworker helps the client understand that all the goals set are completed and the problem of the client is resolved. The earlier phase of studying the client, assessing the problem, and the intervention strategies used to resolve the problem is complete, and that it is not an ongoing process. The caseworker and the client together plan the termination. Each of the intervention methods used is recapitulated by the caseworker to the client so that the client is aware and satisfied of the intervention methods used by the client. By terminating the client, the social caseworker makes the client aware that she or he is able to resolve the problem and to handle similar situations in the future. This is one of the shortest phases in the social casework process. The process of termination is recorded so that caseworker knows the stage at which termination was done and the responses of the client in the termination phase. During the termination phase, caseworker takes the initiative by outlining the SMART goals, confirms the importance of what the client can do and is expected to do in resolving the problem. Termination should also remove some of the misconceptions that the client has had during the entire casework process, and also in the shifting of responsibility by the caseworker to the organization. This phase is basically highlighted by the reassurance of the client's readiness and willingness to function more effectively. Now, the fifth phase is evaluation or follow-up phase. Evaluation focuses on understanding the outcomes of the casework intervention. The evaluation process will enhance the ability of the caseworker and the organization to render better professional services, and also for the client to know how the casework process has been an effective one in the resolution of the problem of the client. The evaluation phase will also help the caseworker and the organization to get a feedback from the client so that the services rendered by the caseworker and the organization can be improved professionally. Thus, the evaluation phase focuses on the process of attaching a value to the social work practice. Follow-up of the client is also essential in the casework process. Follow-up is done so that the social caseworker knows if the client is able to manage the problem and the situation in which the client is in with confidence. During the follow-up phase, the client shows improvement, and if needed, the client can be referred to groups to which he or she can be associated if needed. Initially, follow-up can be done on a weekly basis, and then gradually the duration and frequency of the visits can be reduced. Follow-up process can be done through various ways, face-to-face, telephonic conversation, letters, and so on. The follow-up of the client should also be recorded in the case file maintained by the social caseworker. Thus, developing an understanding of the casework process is essential. The casework process will have to be implemented in a systematic way after thoughtfully planning with the client on the casework process. The intervention should be meaningful and helpful to the client. As a summary of this lesson, we can conclude that social casework process is very essential in order to give an effective help to the person who has come to us for help. The casework process will have to be implemented in a systematic way after thoughtfully planning with the client on the casework process. The intervention should be meaningful and helpful to the client, and it is also essential that after a very thorough assessment has to be evaluated and it has to be followed up so that we know as to how much our interaction, the interventions that has been done, is effective in the life of the client.